Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
We thank the Lord for these days that He has given us to gather in His name. We open our hearts to His love, to His mercy, to the fullness of the Holy Spirit, as we humbly recognize our own sins and failures. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, holy angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. As we recall, year by year, the mysteries by which through the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again. We earnestly beseech your mercy, Lord, that what we celebrate in faith we may possess in an unending love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
In reading from the Acts of the Apostles, the high priest rose up and all his companions, that is, the party of the Sadducees, and had rejoicing, laid hands upon the apostles and put them in the public jail. But during the night, the angel of the Lord opened the doors of the prison, let them out, and said, Go and take your place in the temple area and tell the people everything about this life. When they heard this, they went to the temple early in the morning and thought. When the high priest and his companions arrived, they condemned the Sanhedrin, the full senate of the children of Israel, and sent to the jail to have them brought in. But the court officers could not find them in the prison. So they came up and reported. We found the jail securely locked, and the girls and the crowds stationed outside the doors. But when we were opened them, we found no one inside. When the captain of the temple guard and the chief priest heard this report, they were at a loss about them as to what this would come to. Then someone came in and reported to them, The men whom you put in prison are in the temple area and are teaching the people. Then the captain and the court officers went and brought them, but without force, because they were afraid of being stoned by the people. The word of the Lord. The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The Lord will hear me and be glad. Let us together extol His name. I sought the Lord, and He answered me, and delivered me from all my fears.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
Look to Him that you may be rich and be joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one conquered, the Lord heard, and from all his distress, he saved them.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Bless the man who takes refuge in him.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
He says,
we are in the Easter season. During this season, we are challenged to renew our profession of faith and to make a step from darkness to light, from doubt to faith, and to profess a faith that is really charged with a deep conviction in and through Jesus risen from the dead. That God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him may not be lost, but may have eternal life. As we see the great and amazing transformation in Peter and the rest of the apostles, and the new life budding forth from these Easter people, we go back to our own lives and see our own denials, our fears, our lack of fervor and enthusiasm in the ministry, and we desire to unite ourselves with this first Christian community. to acquire new fervor, new enthusiasm. Now in the first Christian community, we join the church as he invites us to enter the new life with him, with our works being done in God. With them, we desire to be born anew from above, just like the invitation of Jesus to Nicodemus. Today, we also have to personally feel the invitation of Jesus to Thomas, and be not faithless, but believing. Our life is at stake, as he that believed on him is not condemned, but goes to life. The experience of Easter, which culminates in the experience of Pentecost, as Father Rainello Cantalamessa told us, you remember, during the National Retreat in 2010, he said that it is the same as the experience of being embraced by God's love. The Holy Spirit, the reciprocal love between the Father and the Son, embraces us with his warm and loving presence. The experience converts, casts away all fears, and enables one to put everything aside and put one's life into the hands of the Father to go on a mission. This is the experience of the first disciple of Jesus, the first Christian community. This is also the reason why seminary formators are guided and are told that one of the things that they need to see in our candidates to the priesthood is their experience of God's love. They should have this experience, and they should be aware of God walking with them and guiding them every step of the way. Verbum Domini, the most recent pastoral exhortation on the Word of God, reiterated what Dei Verbum had expressed, that the unseen God, from the fullness of his love, addresses men and women as his friends and lives with them in order to invite and receive them into his own company. God makes himself known to us as a mystery of infinite love. In the dialogue of love between the divine persons, and invites us to share in that love. Thus, a word of God is spoken to us and spoken through us is always a word spoken from the fullness of God's love. Thus, it is always an encounter with God's love. This was the reason of the joy and happiness it brought to Jeremiah when he said, "When I found your words, I devoured them. They became my joy and the happiness of my heart, because I bore your name, O Lord, God of hosts." God's love in salvation history and in the history of the church had always revealed himself to every man, highlighted in a way in the lives of our fathers in the faith and the saints. This is still an ongoing reality in the lives of men and women in our time. As preachers of the Easter message called to build Christian communities, we are supposed to witness to this truth. Thus, in all our programs and activities, we have to help people to hear and see that they are indeed embraced by God's love. Let us not hesitate to talk about our experience and the experience of people about God's love. Doing so, we give way for the Holy Spirit to work on our people entrusted to us. And my father is always with me wherever I go, and this past months. And I listened a lot to his stories in San Paulidulet. Pero his stories revealed to me also the reality of God loving me through his story. I was told by my father that when he was 7 years old, both his father and mother died. And he was telling me it's not easy to be an orphan. Many times you are in the dark, many times you are lost. You don't know where to go, you don't know what to do. And he was telling me of one of his uncles telling him and asking him that when he's in the dark, when he's lost, that he goes to a church, or he goes to a chapel, or just in front of an altar, and then pray the Our Father. And he told me, sabi ng tatay ko sa akin, wala akong mintis. From that moment until today, he would always do that. And he is in the dark and pray the Our Father. While praying the Our Father, he receives light. When he is undergoing difficulties, he would always receive the inspiration what to do and where to go. To see the person in his prayers, while praying, the person who can help him. And he was telling me that when he was about to get married, his trauma came back to him and he wanted to back out. And so he entered again to the church and prayed the Our Father. And while praying the Our Father, he felt the assurance that it is God's will that he would marry my mother. And he was so confident that it was God's will that he would marry my mother. When I heard this story, I told my father, buti na lang, nag-asawa ka, kasi kung hindi, wala kami magkakapatid. Wala kami magkakapatid. So one of the gifts I would say that I received when I was ordained a bishop was the fact that both my father and mother are still alive. Sometimes I forget that this is a gift. Naalala ko lang pag sinasabi ng mga kapatid o bispo na swerte mo naman, may tatay ka pa, nanay pa ka. So, my father is now 93 years old and my mother, who is bedridden, is now 90 years old. It's important that we recall always how much the Lord loves us. And that this love continues, doesn't stop. Hindi mean to agavail sa atin. Minsan, natatakpan because of our experiences. I remember when one of my brothers died, total, I would say that he's among my brothers, he's very close to me because he's the one who put open his heart to me. Kasi, kwento niya sa akin na nasa seminaryo ako, higit na higit siya sa akin kasi nga I was given special privileges and as a seminarian and I was given special attention by my parents. And siya yung palaging nagkukumpisa sa akin. Imbaga, yun. At nagkataon na palaging nakapunta din sa funeral niya sa Canada. So when he died, I was affected really by it. So I remember once, I was president of the University of Assumption. And in one of our sharing with the administrators, priest administrators, we read the gospel and we used to share our thoughts and experiences in the gospel. At that time, I felt I just wanted to remain silent. Gusto ko lang magpulong dun sa magkulong sa kwarto. So, I told my brother priest, si na Father Deo, Father Mali, so I told them, ayaw ko na mag-share. Pwede pa kayo lang na lang mag-share. Then one of the priest, si Father Deo, sabi niya sa akin, sure. Gusto din po namin malinig yung karanasan ninyo sa pagkamatay ng kapatid ninyo. We also want to extend our unity and solidarity with you the death of your brother. Ganun yung baka. And that somehow challenged me to go out of myself. And share the grief and the sorrow, the pain, and etc. that I was experiencing. But even after that, I would still would close myself in a room. Basta may pagkakataon, basta magpupulong lang ako. It happened, that time, di ko lang where I got that yung series ng The Last Airbender, di ba lang kung napanood ni Jason yung si Ang, yung nakalibing, literally nakalibing sa yelo. So I realized, parang nakalibing din ako dun sa lungkot at lumbay at sa sakit na nadarama mo while watching that. It was a series, natapos ko yun. But it enabled me to go out of myself. Kung paano si Anne, little by little, was starting to rediscover the power within, the things that he could still do, the ability to save humanity, as in, which he did. So in the same manner, it was like, also for me, rediscovering the power of the risen Lord in me, the power of His love, and the power to start anew. This is also what is being asked of us during this Easter season, to recapture that fervor, to recapture the fire that we have that comes from the risen Lord, and that comes from that experience of being loved and being embraced by God's love. With confidence, we bring our cares and concerns before God the Father, who loved the world so much that He gave His only Son, so that everyone who believes in Him may not be lost, but may have eternal life. With every prayer and petition, let our response be, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
In the name of Jesus, bless us.
That the Church may always be a living sign of God's love and mercy in times of darkness and despair, let us pray to the Lord.
In the name of Jesus, bless us.
That we may live in such a manner that the love of God may shine forth in all our actions, let us pray to the Lord.
In the name of Jesus, bless us.
That the love of God may bring peace into our hearts and harmony in our lives, let us pray to the Lord.
In the name of Jesus, bless us.
That through the care and attention shown by the family or our friends, the sick and those who suffer may realize that they are loved by God. Let us pray to the Lord.
In the name of Jesus, bless us.
That our beloved dead may all share in the glory of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
In the name of Jesus, bless us.
Heavenly Father, look with love on all your children and guide us safely on the in our pilgrim journey. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Rising, the life of all has risen, Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. The mystery of faith.
Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you.